Anti-American NFL players just issued Trump a nasty ultimatum before standing at Sunday game. And yet another ignorant ball tosser stuck his foot in his mouth. The highly overrated Titans wide receiver Rishard Matthews, while responding to a question asked on Twitter by a local TV producer earlier this week, said he would step away from football if the NFL implements a new rule requiring players to stand for the national anthem. But of course, as soon as he tweeted his response, Matthews, who again stayed in the tunnel for the singing of the anthem during Sunday's game against Miami, deleted his tweet. WSMV Channel 4 posted a screen grab of the tweet, which was the response to a question from Matt Parker, who is one of their producers. Now here is what's really strange about this whole story with Matthews is that he actually had a brother killed fighting in Afghanistan and a father who served 23 years in the U.S. military. He did initially speak out against the protest when Colin Kaepernick first decided to kneel last season. But the ball tosser has since changed his mind and now fully supports kneeling during our national anthem. Why the change of heart, Matthews? Who convinced you otherwise? Or who paid you to change your mind? Red State reports. NFL in bed with Soros. Turns out taking a knee to protest police brutality, and later, to protest remarks made by Donald Trump, was mostly political after all. It's being reported today that the National Football League Players Association, NFLPA, the union that represents NFL players and who came out in support of Colin Kaepernick's attempt at social justice activism, has some significant associations with progressive activist and billionaire George Soros. Which is to say, they are aligned with groups that take his money to try to implement the leftist utopia he seeks. From the Washington Times. Tax documents released by conservative watchdog group, Second Vote show that NFLPA donated $5,000 in 2015 to the Center for Community Change Action, a group active in the anti-Trump resistance and bankrolled by a host of liberal foundations, including top Democratic donor George Soros's Foundation for Open Society. A member of the AFL-CIO, the NFLPA also contributed in 2013 and 2015 to Working America, the AFL-CIO's community affiliate, which Open Secrets said spent $1 million in 2016 to defeat Trump. Working America has since mobilized against the Republican tax cut framework, denouncing it as the Trump tax scam. The NFLPA contributed $5,000 in 2014 to Jobs with Justice, another pro-union group backed by Soros, and $5,000 in 2013 to the Progressive Los Angeles Alliance for a New Economy. The NFLPA donations from 2013, 2014 and 2015 were made before Mr. Trump was elected. To recap, the NFLPA likes to give money to groups that are also funded by George Soros, who you may remember as the guy who broke the British bank, may have helped the Nazis by confiscating property of Jewish teenagers in his home country of Budapest, and is the primary funder of the leftist media in this country. Very interesting list of journalists affiliated with Soros at the link. NFLPA also likes to give money to groups that are actively involved in the resistance against Trump, which would explain why there was a backlash to his comments that Kaepernick should be fired for not respecting the flag. But, as noted above, many of the donations to leftist groups came years before Trump was elected. It makes one feel a little sorry for Kaepernick and the rest of the NFL players who, we can assume, might actually believe they are kneeling to make the world a more equitable place. They are, instead, being used as pawns in a political game between huge special interests, and their union, who is supposed to look after them, is complicit in the charade. Maybe they figured it out since there appears to be more standing going on every week, with the original 200 players taking a knee dropping to about 50 last week. Don't be fooled by all the left-wing talking points from today's sportscasting wannabe social justice warriors. All these ball tossers aren't known for their high IQs. They are just bought and paid to think the way they do. None of them have real convictions other than their love for money and fame. In a way, who can blame them since they aren't really good for much else, so they have to milk the system for every cent they can. And since now we have a concrete link between the NFL and the evil globalist leftist George Soros, who suffers from a God complex, we can now confirm the suspicion many of us had about all these protests. These protests started as a way for Colin Kaepernick to remain in the spotlight once the San Francisco 49ers decided he wasn't good enough to be a starter anymore. But it later turned into a protest against our president, the very president most NFL fans support. The globalists have wanted to end American football for decades. They finally succeeded.